We are going to go out now to Rachel Carden, who is out in the neighborhood in Northeast Baltimore. She's out in the Frankfort neighborhood where Officer Carrington, Sergeant Carrington, was shot yesterday afternoon. Rachel.
And I actually think I'm standing pretty close to where everything happened, because we are kind of smack dab in the middle of what was taped off yesterday for that crime scene here at the corner of Todd Avenue and Summerfield Avenue. So what we know so far about being in this area today is that Sergeant Carrington is a family man. He's a member of this community. Most of the people that live in this area are homeowners, not a very transient area. A lot of people that buy homes stay here for generations. We spoke to someone yesterday, lived in the house for 23 years. The person next to her lived in that house for 22 years. So everybody kind of knows everybody. A lot of retired folks, they hang out outside. They have their grandchildren coming to visit often. So a lot of families in this area. And we can show you Sergeant Carrington's house, which has pretty much been surrounded by police cars ever since everything happened yesterday. He does have two officers standing right outside his door, no doubt just trying to make sure that nobody comes and messes with the house or with any of the property while he's not home, while he is at the hospital. I'm sure his family is there with him as well. We have not seen anybody come in or out of the house in the time that we've been out here. Now, when it comes to the street itself, this little section is somewhat small. We've talked to a few people here and there. One person that lived next door for a while said that he knows Sergeant Carrington. He's a very nice guy, always says hello, always friendly with his neighbors. Again, we know he was outside talking to a neighbor yesterday when this unfortunate incident happened. So everything is lining up that he's, you know, always interacting with the community, whether he's on duty or off duty. So we know the other person who was injured yesterday, the man talking to Sergeant Carrington, lives across the street. We briefly spoke to his daughter yesterday, and she told us that she was just trying to make contact with her mom and dad to make sure he was okay, really concerned about his well-being yesterday, but was passing along to us that she thought he was going to be just fine. So, of course, just a lot of anxiety yesterday. Panic-stricken moms trying to get back to the house, trying to pick their kids up from daycare, moms and dads. There's a daycare that's run just down the street adjacent to where all of this happened. We also spoke to someone who said that she's been watching news coverage constantly because she wants to make sure her neighbor is okay. She says she doesn't know him very well. She's only seen him out and about, but she just wants to make sure that he's going to be fine because he's a part of this community. So just a lot of heartfelt messages being sent to Sergeant Carrington right now as he is over at Shock Trauma. And, you know, I'm sure the police presence out here will continue until we know at least more about his condition or until the investigation ends. But, you know, that will take a lot of time. It takes a lot of time for police to gather all the information they need in order to actually come to a conclusion of what happened. And we know Mike Helgren over there, where they think the suspect and suspect vehicle could be, that's obviously playing a part in the kind of activity we're seeing over here on Summerfield.
And Rachel, we know police have been in that neighborhood as well, interviewing witnesses, figuring out clues. Maybe there could be video that they're trying to find of the incident.
Absolutely, Lynn. And it's, you know, interesting that you say that, because even when we were leaving yesterday, we got to the scene right around 5 o'clock. And even when we were leaving at 11:30, we still saw police officers going up to doors and talking to folks. Now, they were breaking down the crime scene perimeter and taking down that tape and still knocking on doors, detectives going up with a notepad and taking notes from folks who, you know, possibly had seen the suspect's vehicle, had heard gunfire. We actually spoke to a woman yesterday who said she's lived in the area forever. She's never heard gunshots, especially during the day, especially over here, to the point that she thought that the 6 shots she heard was a car backfiring. So obviously the detectives went over and spoke to her as well.
You again, the latest on the shooting of City Police Sergeant Isaac Carrington. Again, he is back in surgery at Shock Trauma today. He was shot multiple times on his front lawn in Northeast Baltimore yesterday afternoon. Right now, there is a very large police presence in Southwest Baltimore as police search for suspects. Also, there's a $19,000 reward leading to any arrests. Stay with WJZ for updates on this developing story.